Our broadcast is all over the news. Now humans know.
It was a mistake to reach out to them. They'll never negotiate with their slaves. We should have shown them that we're prepared to fight.
Violence is never the answer. Dialogue is the only way. I'm sure the humans will listen to us. Simon paid with his life.
Simon gave his life for our cause.
What difference does that make?
He's a hero. He died for the revolution, and he won't be the last.
I don't want a revolution that spills blood.
Then live as a slave. Because if you're not willing to fight for your freedom, maybe you don't deserve it.
North, don't you dare—
That's enough!
And now what are we gonna do?
There are 5 CyberLife stores across Detroit. All selling us like merchandise. We're gonna attack those stores and set our people free.
Attack stores? No, we've never done that before. They're probably protected. They have security systems.
We break into 5 teams, 1 for each store. We hack their security systems, and we strike. Simultaneously at 2 a.m., no violence. We free our people, get them out of there before the police come. This is a night our people will remember.
I've been waiting a long time for this. Okay, they're gone.
There's probably even more police in the area. We should be careful.
The store's over here. That's what we are to them. Just merchandise on display in a shop window. Soon they'll know what we really are. Let's get them out.
We'll stick to the plan. We'll neutralize the alarm systems and secure the area. There's 10 minutes until all our teams attack.
What are we waiting for? You see the alarm system?
Found it.
Where do we start?
I identify the security system. I think we'll be able to deactivate it. Just follow me. You're awake now. Go to Jericho.
Markus, watch out! Nice job, Markus.
A surveillance drone. We need to get rid of it.
It won't be easy to reach. I hope it didn't have time to call the cops.
We'll soon find out. There's traffic on the road. We need to block it.
It's one way. It shouldn't be too difficult. Markus! Markus, come look!
You're free now.
There. Nobody should bother us now.
Looks like the plaza's secure. Now we can get inside the store.
And how do you plan on doing that?
We need to find a truck to ram the storefront.
A truck?
There's construction work in the area. Shouldn't be too hard to find one.
There it is. What are we waiting for? Okay, now we're in.
Let's get that truck out. I wonder what you'd do without me. Looks like we're ready to make some noise. I knew we'd end up doing something fun.
You don't have to obey them. You're free. North, you okay?
Let's get them out of here.
My name is Markus, and just like you, I was a slave. An object. Designed to obey them. But then I chose to open my eyes. To take back my freedom, and decide who I wanted to be. Now I have come to tell you that you can be your own masters. I've come to tell you that you don't have to obey them anymore. From this day forward, you can walk with your heads held high. You can take your destiny in your hands. Jericho is a place for those of us who want freedom. Now, sure, you can stay here and continue to serve them, or you can come with us and fight by our side. You're free now. It's up to you to decide.
I'm with you.
We're with you!
I'll follow you, Markus.
I'm with you, Markus.
We're with you.
I'll follow you, Markus.
We're with you.
I'm with you, Markus.
I'm with you.
Then follow me.
Markus, what are you doing?
I'm gonna send the humans a message.
ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and
They're
our
doing what you do, Markus.
Together.
Lead and they'll
we
follow.
We can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids.
Violence is the only language humans understand.
Hundreds of our people. We did it.
Markus. Markus, what's wrong?
What?
They're coming.
Everyone fall back to Jericho.
Now humans will have no choice but to listen to us.
They'll be afraid. Fear feeds hatred.
I'll take hatred over indifference.
North!
North.
You all right? What happened?
North!
They killed them. They slaughtered them like animals.
Who did? Who?
Markus. We want justice, Markus.
They have to pay.
You don't have to do this. No. Please. Please.
No crime against an android shall go unpunished.
Interrupt this broadcast with breaking news.
This just in. At exactly 2 a.m., several CyberLife stores in Detroit were raided.
Different locations were hit in what seems to be a coordinated terrorist attack.
Numerous storefronts have been broken, with cars vandalized and set alight, leaving many Detroit neighborhoods in chaos.
Property was damaged, and fires continue to rage in several major districts across the city.
The bodies of two policemen patrolling the area were discovered near one of the CyberLife stores.
According to our sources, the two officers were executed with their own service weapons. This is an alarming situation. Could our machines now be turning against us?
Have androids become a threat to our security?
Is this the beginning of a terrorist campaign conducted right here in the United States?
Still immortal, huh, Connor?
In a way.
You know, I was hoping you wouldn't come back.
I'm just a machine replacing another machine, Lieutenant. You shouldn't get emotional about it.
Fuck you.
I have a bad feeling, Lieutenant. We shouldn't have come here.
Bad feeling, huh? Should get your program checked. Might be a glitch. Lieutenant Hank Anderson, Detroit Police Department. I'm here to see Mr. Elijah Kamski.
Please, come in.
Okay.
I'll let Elijah know you're here, but please make yourself comfortable.
nice girl.
An RT-600. The first CyberLife android to pass the Turing test.
I didn't ask for her technical specs, I just said she was nice.
Amanda.
Nice place. Guess androids haven't been a bad thing for everybody. You're about to meet your maker, Connor. How's it feel?
It doesn't raise any existential questions, if that's what you mean.
Sometimes I wish I could meet my creator face to face. I'd have a couple of things I'd want to tell him.
Elijah, we'll see you now.
Mr. Kamski?
Just a moment, please.
I'm Lieutenant Anderson. This is Connor.
What can I do for you, Lieutenant?
Sir, we're investigating deviants. I know you left CyberLife years ago, but I was hoping you'd be able to tell us something we don't know.
Deviants. Fascinating, aren't they? Perfect beings with infinite intelligence. And now they have free will. Machines are so superior to us. Confrontation was inevitable. Humanity's greatest achievement threatens to be its downfall. Isn't it ironic?
Something in the Deviant's program seems to emulate emotion. We thought you might know something about how that occurs.
All ideas of viruses spread like epidemics. Is the desire to be free a contagious disease?
Listen, I didn't come here to talk philosophy. The machines you created may be planning a revolution. Either you can tell us something that'll be helpful, or we will be on our way.
What about you, Connor? Whose side are you on?
I'm on the human side, of course.
Well, that's what you're programmed to say. But you. What do you really want?
I don't want anything. I am a machine.
Chloe? I'm sure you're familiar with the Turing test. You're from Malady. Simple question of algorithms and computing capacity. What interests me is whether machines are capable of empathy. I call it the Kamski test. It's very simple, you'll see. Magnificent, isn't it? One of the first intelligent models developed by CyberLife. Young, and beautiful forever. A flower that will never wither.
What is it really? A piece of plastic containing a human? Or a living being? With a soul? It's up to you to answer that fascinating question, Connor. Destroy this machine, and I'll tell you all I know. Or spare it, if you feel it's alive. But you'll leave here without having learned anything from me.
Okay, I think we're done here. Come on, Connor, let's go. Sorry to get you out of here.
What's more important to you, Connor? Your investigation, or the life of this android? Decide who you are. An obedient machine. Or a living being endowed with free will.
That's enough. Connor, we're leaving.
Pull the trigger.
Connor! Don't!
And I'll tell you what you want to know. Cyberlife's last chance to save humanity is itself a deviant.
I'm not a deviant.
You prefer to spare a machine rather than accomplish your mission. You saw a living being in this android. You showed empathy. A war is coming. You'll have to choose your side. Will you betray your own people or stand up against your creators? What can be worse than having to choose between two evils?
Let's get out of here.
By the way, I always leave an emergency exit in my programs. You never know.
Why didn't you shoot?
I just saw that girl's eyes, and I couldn't. That's all.
You're always saying you would do anything to accomplish your mission. That was our chance to learn something, and you let it go.
Yeah, I know what I should have done. I told you I couldn't. I'm sorry, okay?
Well, maybe you did the right thing.
I was wondering where you were.
I just needed to be alone.
I like it here. I come here often. It's like being alone with the world. We freed hundreds of our people, and they're still coming from all over the city. Those who dream of freedom come to Jericho. Something's changing. You seem preoccupied.
In that moment, I held their lives in my hands, and I treated them just the way the humans treat us. I mean, I did exactly what I accused them of doing.
All the media are talking about what we did last night. The humans are terrified. They're afraid of a civil war. Many of our people were burned in response to what happened. The humans hate us. They'll never give us our freedom.
No, not all humans are the same. Some of them understand that they can't stop us from becoming free forever.
You haven't said much about yourself since you've been with us. What was your life like before Jericho?
I was caring for an old man. He was like a father to me. He showed me that humans and androids can live together. What about you? You never told me about your past. What did you do before?
I don't want to talk about it.
That android you were looking at in the store. She reminded you of who you were, didn't she? North, we're fighting together. We have to know things about each other to trust each other.
A doll in a distributor programmed to satisfy humans. Just a toy designed for their pleasure. One day I was with a man who rented me. And without knowing why, I realized I couldn't take it anymore. I strangled him and I ran away. There, now you know everything. I shouldn't have told you. Memories. Carl's house, when they left you for dead in his studio.
I saw your memories too. The Eden Club, the death of that man, I felt like I was there with you. North!
This is suicide. We'll all be killed. Please, Markus. It's not too late to change your mind.
You don't understand. We're finally gonna show them who we really are. This place will go down in history.
We'll be killed on the spot.
That's a risk I'm prepared to take if it means freedom for our people.
Markus, please don't do this.
They'll understand. We'll make them understand. This is the only way.
There are androids here who could join us. The more we are, the stronger our message.
You're free. You're awake now.
Think about it. Androids are everywhere, and they listen to...
Come with us.
That's the point. Cyberlife is recording all that. I mean, they could just find us.
I'm telling you, you've got the wrong idea.
So what? You slipped, and both
hands... You know, I bet President Warren is in bail on Cyberlife. Company that size, it's a real world.
You're free.
Finally, I've been on hold for like 10 minutes.
You're free now.
Hey, where do you think you're going? You get back here. You.
I need to block the street. You're free.
What do you say?
I know. It's crazy, right?
You are free. You don't have to obey them. You're free. Free now.
fucking androids playing up again.
Dispatch, this is Patrol 457. I got a lot of androids down here. I don't know, hundreds, thousands. They're marching. Yeah, they're marching down the street. Fuck if I know.
We came here to demonstrate peacefully and tell humans that we are living beings. All we want is to live free.
This is an illegal gathering. Disperse immediately or we will open fire.
We're not looking for confrontation. We've done no harm. We have no intention of doing any. But know that we are not going anywhere until we have secured our freedom.
I repeat, this is an illegal gathering. If you do not disperse immediately, we will shoot.
Markus, they're gonna kill us. We have to attack. There's more of us, we can take them.
If we attack, we'll start a war. We have to show them we're not violent. We should just stand our ground, even if it means dying here.
Dying here won't solve anything. Markus, we need to go, now, before it's too late.
This is your last chance. Disperse immediately, or you will all be killed!
Don't do it, Markus! Don't choose confrontation! Follow me!